So I interned at two places, and both of them were luxury brands. One is Ports 1961 and the other one is Chanel. I mean, Chanel was one of my dream come true. And I was just so glad when I received this opportunity, they were willing to sponsor, and I said yes in a heartbeat. Students studying in the US or students studying abroad and having such an amazing experiences, because you do end up finding courses to pick from which actually widen your horizon even more. So I ended up picking fashion merchandising, and I did a fast track program, which essentially means that I was able to transfer some of my undergrad credits and was able to complete a course which normally takes students a year and a half to 2 years. I was able to complete it in 1 year. Hi everyone, my name is Deepshika and I currently live and work in New York City. A little bit about me before I jump into the specifics of my life in New York, especially my journey from India to New York. As long as I remember, I have always wanted to work in the fashion industry in some capacity, and I've always dreamt of living and working in the United States, specifically New York. I moved to New York in 2014, around 8 years back, to study fashion merchandising at Parsons School of Design. And having lived with my parents all my life, this is probably the biggest step I took in order to pursue my dreams and live independently. Also, I remember when I moved to New York, the first 2 weeks, I was so scared. I wanted to go back. I cried straight for a week. And I was like, did I make the biggest mistake of my life? Because, you know, I always had a very sheltered life back home. But once school started and I got the taste of New York, there was absolutely no looking back. I fell in love with the city. As most high school students, I found myself extremely confused about what I wanted to study for my undergrad program. I was always interested in something creative, but I wasn't sure how to go about it, and I did not have the biggest support from my family in order to pursue something creative or out of the box. So I ended up doing commerce, specializing in accounting and finance. Now, one of the reasons why I decided to move to New York, especially to study here, was because the education system in India, according to me, it does not encourage practical training. And that was a problem for me because I heard a lot of stories from friends and family friends about students studying in the US or students studying abroad and having such an amazing experiences, because you do end up finding courses to pick from which actually widen your horizon even more. You're not restricted to just do a certain kind of subjects. So I found that so liberating and interesting, and I was like, I really want to study in the US because I do not relate to the education system in India, because it's all about getting an A. It's all about getting the best scores in the class. It's all about mugging up your chapters and then taking exams. So that was not fun for me. And I found if I did pursue something, that would really help me in a lot of different ways. And I think that was one of the reasons why I decided to move to New York. Another important factor why I decided to move was, I mean, I grew up in a very conservative, protective family where, you know, you're not allowed to make your own decisions. You can't live life on your own terms. And somewhere I feel, you know, you're not utilizing your potential to the fullest. And to me, that was a problem. I wanted to be able to voice my opinions. I wanted to be able to be heard or to make certain decision or life choices that actually help a person grow and evolve. And hence, this was another big factor for me to leave home and move away, which would really help me grow as a person in life and to be able to face life struggles in a better way. So this is one of the reasons why I moved too. Right after college got over, I got an opportunity to work as a fashion buyer at a multi-designer store in Kolkata itself. I was able to travel to fashion weeks. I worked with a ton of designers. I was in charge of making sure we have products fulfilled for the store, it was an exciting job, but I think 1 year into the job, I realized how badly I wanted to pursue fashion studies, specifically on the business side. And I don't know why, but in 2013, I ended up applying to London College of Fashion, and I got admitted, and I was actually considering London for a few weeks, till one of my friends from Delhi messaged and saying, if you want to study fashion, you have to go to Parsons and you have to go to New York City. So I, you know, he asked me to basically pick New York and Parsons over London College of Fashion. And I think that was a starting point of my journey from India to New York, because the minute I saw his text, I was like, why didn't I apply to Parsons? Because I have been watching Parsons throughout my life, specifically through shows such as Project Runway, Top Design. And I remember when I used to watch those shows, I was always so eager and would always daydream that someday I hope I can make it to Parsons. And I did, and it's so exciting. The reason why I picked AAS in fashion merchandising was that back in 2013, Parsons did not offer a ton of programs in fashion business studies. So I ended up picking fashion merchandising, and I did a fast track program, which essentially means that I was able to transfer some of my undergrad credits and was able to complete a course which normally takes students a year and a half to 2 years. I was able to complete it in 1 year. That was really helpful because I was not able to afford tuition beyond a year. So I got really lucky with that. And while I was at Parsons, I got to study a lot of like fun subjects such as retail math, production methods, color theory, fabric textiles. And I think all these subjects did help me a little bit with my current job, because it did teach me a little bit about how fabrics and products are developed. And that's what I currently do, which I'm going to talk a little more about later in the video. During my course, I managed to squeeze in two fantastic internships. I mean, they were just amazing. I remember a lot of people warned me, or a lot of people had a ton of opinions about how difficult internships are in New York, how interns are not treated well. And I was a little scared, to be honest, but I had the best experience because both my internships, so I interned at two places and both of them were luxury brands. One is Ports 1961 and the other one is Chanel. I mean, Chanel was one of my dream come true to intern at. So yeah, I had a great, great experience at both the internships and made some really great connections. So if someone is telling you that it's not going to be easy or difficult, I mean, I just feel people should have an open mind and go in with positivity. And I think it pays back in positive ways. After a year of studies, I actually realized coming to Parsons and New York was more of a life learning experience than anything else. I mean, obviously I got to learn a lot in school, but for me, it was bigger than that, because I lived in a bubble back home. I lived in a very protective environment. I didn't know how to do things by myself. I was very dependent on my family. It was a very challenging and enriching experience, but it took me years to gather the courage to apply and leave. And it was really hard, but honestly, it was probably the best decision I made, because I have grown so much as a person, and I would encourage everyone who's able to learn to live alone and independently, because that's how you learn how to really go through life struggles and challenges and deal with life in a bigger picture. After completing two intense semesters, I found myself extremely worried and stressed about securing a full-time job with a company that would eventually sponsor me. It wasn't easy at all, and I was extremely disappointed because I was told at most interviews that sponsorship was not going to be an option. However, I was extremely determined, and I just did not think otherwise, because I think somewhere, at my core, I had a very strong belief that there had to be some company out there that would be willing to sponsor, because my goal was not just to come here, study for a year, do my OPT for a year and then leave. I really wanted to build my career. I wanted to build myself, establish myself in New York City. So I did not give up on the idea that there is a company out there that would be willing to sponsor. At the beginning of 2015, I was asked to interview with one of my professors at Parsons, who for an opportunity at a fashion startup he was helping out with. I guess the interview went well because I received an offer within a week, and you know what they say about being at the right place at the right time. Luck played a factor, but I think I was so determined and had such a strong belief that I felt in a way I manifested this opportunity, because I was told by so many people like sponsorship is not gonna happen. And I was just so glad when I received this opportunity, they were willing to sponsor, and I said yes in a heartbeat. And here I am with the same company 7-8 years later, which I'm gonna talk more about. Working at a fashion startup was probably the best learning experience one could ask for. Being the first full-time employee, I remember working around the clock. I put in 12 to 13 hours every single day, including most weekends. The job was extremely challenging, but fulfilling at the same time because it was extremely entrepreneurial. I remember in 2017, when Untucked started showing massive growth in the market, I was able to build my own department and build my own team, and I shifted more towards product development. Over a period of time, Untucked ended up having 80 stores in the country. It expanded to London and Canada through stores. It's one of the most sought after e-commerce brands for men, primarily for men. We do women's as well, but very little. And in a nutshell, I lead a team of 5 talented individuals, and we all work with costing, sourcing strategy, negotiations, time and action calendars, production cash flow. If you want to know more about Untucked and what I do and my work and my job, please leave a comment below with your questions. I'm going to end the video with a little information about my visa struggles and sponsorship. And if you guys want to know more, please leave a comment below with your questions and I'd be happy to answer them. Visa struggle was something I anticipated, but not to such an extent, because it can get very tricky with the whole lottery system associated with H-1B. I was sponsored 5 years in a row, and finally I got my H-1B this year in 2021. And honestly, if I had better knowledge, if I did better research, I would have picked master's over an AAS, because the higher the degree, the higher are your chances of making it in the lottery. And I decided to pursue my master's and ended up finding a university which fortunately and thank God offered a work permit from day one, which means I was not only able to maintain my status, I was also able to continue working. And at the same time, I was learning a completely new program, which was data analytics. So it was a lot of, I juggled a lot. Like I studied during the weekend, I worked during the week, and I finally have my degree. And if you guys want to know more about that, please leave a comment.